just like a rose from the concrete. Valley of death, no palm trees. Yeah, how with words, that's what I speak. Trying to revive the dead like an IV. Just like a farmer, I just plant seeds. Tell the harvest right and let the Lord reap. Christ, they strung us up and hung us on trees. Now we get the earth and the seven seas. Kingdom seek is heavenly. Gospel what I'm peddling. When you at war, ain't no need.
Big bro, you got a question? Or are you just listening?
Yeah, I just got in.
What's your ethnicity? You said indigenous?
Yeah, Inca.
Inca? Bet. All praise the Most High. You would come from the tribe, most likely. Was that Issachar? Oh, I'm tripping, huh? That's Zebulon? All right, bet. You would mostly come from the tribe of Zebulon, right? If that's Inca, right? Give him a hand. You see what I'm saying? What's going on, bro? You straight? All right. So basically, well, here's what we're doing, right? We're out here teaching that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, they are God's chosen people, all right? Have you ever wondered why are we the best at everything? You look at Mexican, you look at Latinos just in general, they know how to cook, they know how to dance, they know how to make good music. If you look at black people in general, they know how to cook, they know how to dance, they know how to make good music and entertainment, right? We're the best at everything, yet we're at the lowest, all right? Well, why is that? Why did God do that?
Looking at every physical body,
uh-huh,
and spirit here,
right?
You know, they're all mixed too with,
exactly,
like the whole world, you know.
Right. What do you mean by that? Explain.
Pedro.
You said what?
Pedro.
Pedro? Yeah. I'm sorry, bro. I don't know that. You know what they mean?
Pedro.
Yeah.
Pedro, yeah, Spanish
name. Oh, okay. Baby.
Peter.
Gotcha.
Also on the.
At the apocrypha door. Give me a second address. Right. Let me tell you something. Right. How did the Latinos and Hispanics get over here to the New World? How did that happen?
We were already here.
Huh? You said what?
We were already here.
Ah, exactly, right? You got, from what we know in history, you guys are already here. When Columbus and the white people came over here, right? They lied to us in school and said they were the first people here. While at the same time saying, right, they discovered you guys here.
Right.
So that's kind of ridiculous. Just want to throw that out there, right? I'm gonna show you how you guys got here, because at one point in time, right, if you want, huh?
Go ahead.
Yeah, at one point in time, if you want to be honest about it, right, when we look at the 12 tribes of Israel, being that you guys are from the 12 tribes of Israel, right, y'all was on the eastern side of the world. The 12 tribes are on the eastern side of the world at one point. So now that begs the question, how did they get over here? How y'all sisters doing? Y'all might want to stay and listen, right? Jesus Christ is black. All right, give me that. Yeah, y'all come listen. All right.
This the book of...
Go ahead.
This is the book of 2 Ezra, chapter 13, starting at verse 40.
It's going to tell you how the northern kingdom got over here. Because at first, y'all was over there. How did they get over here, right?
Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners,
uh-huh,
out of their own land at the time of Hosea, the king.
The 9 tribes, right? You got people outside of Judah, Benjamin, Levi. Those are the northern kingdom, right? Those are the other tribes, right? You want?
It says, whom Salmaneser, the king of Assyria,
uh-huh,
led away captive.
Uh-huh. So at first, you guys, on the other side of the world, y'all was in captivity. Whether you believe it or not, y'all was actually in captivity as well.
It says, whom Salmaneser, the king of Assyria,
uh-huh,
led away captive.
Uh-huh.
And he carried them over the waters,
uh-huh,
and so came they into another land.
Right.
But they took this counsel among themselves,
right,
that they would leave the multitude of the heathen.
So y'all wanted to escape captivity, to come over here and keep the commandments. This is why you see certain artifacts, like there's a Native American artifact. I forgot it's called, like the some stone. I forgot what was it called.
The Decalogue stone.
Yeah, something like that, right? With the Ten Commandments on it, right? Right. You got stuff like that, right? You came over here. You seen certain Hebrew writings as well, right? It's a bunch of artifacts that we see pertaining to the Hispanic culture. Also, if you look back as well, right, the way y'all governed y'all system back in there in that time was by the Ten Commandments, right? So we're reading the Bible, the so-called New Testament, and majority of that was over the eastern side of the world, wherever the case may be. And majority of the Bible, just in general, was over the eastern side of the world. How on the western side of the world did you guys, right, obtain Eastern traditions? How did you get those, right? I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna tell you guys right here.
It says, but they took this counsel among themselves that they would leave the multitude of the heathen,
uh-huh,
and go forth into a further country,
uh-huh,
where never mankind dwelt.
What is this continent where never mankind dwelt? What is that? At one point, what was it? The white man already told you it's called the New World, right? At one point, nobody was over here until you guys escaped captivity and came over here and dwelt here. right? And actually stayed here, right? This is why you see you guys keeping the Ten Commandments during your civilizations. This is why you see certain, this is why you see certain artifacts as well, right? Pertaining to Hebrew traditions, right? You guys are the Hebrews as well, just like so-called black people, right? Which is why we clearly relate to each other in every aspect way. The only thing that's different between us is probably the accent, right? And the language, right? But even that's the same between us because we got our language from the same oppressor, right? One just having to be conquistador, one having to be, you know, English or whatever the case may be. Those are still the same people, you right? So we just need you to understand that. Did you have a point? Hold on.
When, like, the world was, like, before it got divided into continents, it was just, like, one.
It was Pangea.
Like, the tribe just, like, spread off, you know?
No. What I'm saying is, right, the 12 tribes of Israel, right, this whole thing right here, all 12 tribes, which one of them you come from is Zebulun, right? At one point, right?
Wait, you said come over here?
Yeah, you guys came over here, right?
You're saying to the west?
No, hear me out, right? Yeah, to the west. All 12 tribes at one point was over the eastern side of the world, right? The northern tribes, which is not Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, right? Those are the southern tribes. These guys from Simeon on down, they was on the eastern side of the world at one point. They came over here, right? You see what I'm saying? And they started doing keeping Hebrew traditions, right? As we just read in the Bible,
so
for sure.
To the scripture, Incas came from
Zebulun.
Zebulun?
Yes, sir. You're from Zebulun, right? More than likely.
So when you deal with it, right, there is a family that was passed down. This person named Chief Joseph, right? He had a tablet called Chief Joseph tablet. In Assyria, and decided to leave Assyria to come to what we know as the Americas so that they wouldn't have oppressors preventing them from keeping their culture the way they wanted. You see what I'm saying?
So this is like about like 2,000 years?
Exactly. A little bit further than 2,000 years.
Yeah, 5,000 years.
I said roughly about 2,700 years ago.
Come on, come on.
You see what I'm saying? So you have a little bit further.
Yeah, because there's even like before the Incas, like you had, because there's just so many different like tribes in the territorial. Beetle, Quechua name, is that original language?
Right.
And like the Nazcas, they're like the ancestors of the Incas itself. And
right.
What's going? I don't mean to cut you off, brother. What's going on? Y'all doing a YouTube video.
About, like,
y'all came here for a concert. What concert?
You know Lil Tecca?
Yeah, he's trash. But here's hold on, stop. This is the true concert, right? This is the true concert. Guess what we're talking about? We're talking about the Bible. We're going to perform truth. You guys about truth? I see he did this, right? And I believe him.
What
I believe.
I need to know. I want to hear.
You don't like Tecca, though?
Huh?
You don't like Lil Tecca?
No, sir. Hear me out on this, though, all right? This right here is not truth, right? We're out here to present things that are not truth, have people question it, and then get them the actual truth. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Right? So this, who is this, brother? The devil. You should know that already.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? This is the devil, right? Portraying to be something that you're not, especially if it's God's son, portraying to be God's son and you're actually not, wouldn't only the devil do that?
Definitely.
Right? But who actually did it on actual planet Earth? No. Here's the perpetration. Here's the fraud right here. Portraying to be Jesus.
Yeah.
Who set this up? What do you mean? He's right there.
The white man?
There you go, brother.
The white man,
right? The white man did all this, right? When you actually get down to it, right? Jesus isn't white, and I'm sure these two know that as well, right? Huh? Not really. I don't. I mean, I don't, right? But I ain't got no. I don't know y'all. Yeah, I really don't. I wouldn't trust them. You see what I'm saying? Because, well, hold on. Here's the reason why. When the Native Americans tried trusting white people, what happened?
Woo!
Are we supposed to be learning from history? Ain't that the reason why we got history class? So, but brother, you're not. Obviously, you hadn't done your history. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
It's no knock against them. It's the way God created them. You see what I'm saying? Right, hey, give me that Romans, the things aforetime before I learned it. Let me show you something. You ugly. right? He just is. I'm gonna be honest. He just is. He just is. Let me give you our scripture, right? To prove what I just said. You said what again?
I got you.
Know that you're an Israelite. All right, Jesus Christ in the Bible, he was from the tribe of Judah.
Ain't this what Kanye be talking about?
Yes, yeah. There you go. Kanye, Kodak, Kendrick Lamar, all the K's, right?
Kyrie,
all the K's. You see what I'm saying?
Are they right, though?
Yes, they're right, obviously. Is Jesus white or black? He's black. It's in the Bible, though, what he looks like.
The Bible, he's black?
Yeah. Okay. But let me give you a scripture. Let me give you a Jesus scripture. Don't run from the Jesus scripture.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 15, verse 4. It says, for whatsoever things were written aforetime.
It was written aforetime, not to trust your enemies. Keep going.
Were written for our learning.
Uh-huh.
That we, through patience and comfort of the scriptures, might have hope.
So in the Bible, right, it says never trust your enemies. If the Native Americans would have just simply followed that, maybe this wouldn't have happened. Maybe what they did wouldn't have happened. You see what I'm saying? That's learning from your mistakes, right? And that's all we try to do is learn from our mistakes. And I'm sure they can agree with that or understand it at least, right? Right? You got a scripture?
It's the book of Sirach, chapter 12, verse 10. It says, never trust thine enemy.
This is in the Bible. You going?
For like as iron rust, so is his wickedness.
See that? Never trust your enemies, right? Because they're gonna just cross you at the end of the day, right? You know how we be, in the black community, we like to be your own people. A lot of our own people are our enemies, right? Right, but we gotta learn to trust each other. Right, that's the reason why people can come in and still do what they do to us, right? Because we're a joke at this point, right? This is why they can do what they do to us, right? Now let me show you what Jesus Christ looks like. Give me Acts 13 and 1 real quick.
You only hear one more, though.
We gotta
go.
Though. I only hear one more, so should I get dip or? Let's go. All right, I got you.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 13, verse 1.
We finna read about two Jews. These are Jews now, right?
Now there were in the church that was in Antioch certain prophets and teachers, as Barnabas and Simeon.
Barnabas and Simeon, these are two Jews. You want?
That was called nigger.
It was called what?
Called nigger.
It was called what?
Called nigger.
Right, in the Greek, that word nigger is actually pronounced nigger. That's how you pronounce it. So white people back then was calling us niggers. And when you read, hold on, if you read it in other translations, it's literally going to say black man.
Black man.
It's going to say the black man, literally.
Right. It's in the Bible?
Show.
Yeah, he's right.
Damn, you see what I'm saying? All right. So, outside of that, where else have we heard the word nigger?
White people be saying that shit.
To who?
To black people.
Right. So therefore, Jesus Christ and the Jews are right. Black people. So who are those white people over there? Who are those white people over there calling themselves the Jews?
Right.
Who Kanye is adamantly saying are not the real Jews.
I was just gonna say that.
Exactly. Even he getting it.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So let me ask you a question. Say you had children. Say if you had children, right? And obviously they'd probably be white. And let's say they went missing, right? And you put them on the news one of the names of your children, but it's a black person on the screen. Are you gonna be mad? Yes or no?
I'm gonna be confused.
Are you gonna be mad? Yes or no? Because your child's never gonna get found at that point.
Oh yeah, I'm mad.
Right. How much more for God's children?
Right.
What?
How much more for God's children? Because this is a perpetrating fraud, right? Here's a picture of Jesus Christ, who's actually a black man that we just explained, right? But it's not him. This is a white person.
Yeah.
So shouldn't God be mad about this? This is his son.
Yeah. Right.
Right?
Bro.
So
right.
What would you do, somebody? You'd be ready to kill.
Yeah.
So God's going to be ready to kill.
Yeah.
That's right.
For the people that did this.
He right.
So, that's all I
appreciate y'all, man.
No problem. I can't do that. It's coronavirus. I'm going to be honest with you. It's corona. Huh?
We'll
stick your hand up. We'll see. Look. I'm just fucking with you. Hey, sisters, come hear this word. Hey. Okay, you got a question? No, you good. You got a question? You said how long ago? It's a new day. Yeah, hey, I see y'all. Hey, sisters, I see y'all back. Y'all trying to get the word real quick or what?
Y'all need to take those devil horns and
Is this Jesus? Is this Jesus?
I don't know what Jesus looks like.
Go to Jesus. All right. Is this Jesus, sister?
They said that's
not
him.
So why?
They said that's not him, but that's still rude.
No, it's rude. It's rude to put horns on somebody that tried to. Let me ask you a question, right? Okay, got you, right? Jesus Christ, right? It's when only the devil try to perpetrate to be Jesus Christ and he's not?
Say it one more time.
When somebody of the devil only try to perpetrate Jesus Christ and they're actually not Jesus? When only the devil do that? Try to be Jesus and they're actually not?
When only the devil
right.
portray to be
somebody, Jesus. Somebody that's saying that they're Jesus, right? And they're actually not.
Absolutely. Yes.
That only the devil. So is this Jesus? Is this white man Jesus?
Again, I don't know what he looks like.
Can I show you?
I put my opinions on
Can I show you? Can I show you what it looks like?
Absolutely.
Can I show you what it looks like? It's in the Bible.
I understand. I've read that verse about what he looks like and how he is. I got it. But I don't know what he looks like. You feel me? I couldn't read it. I still don't know what he looked like. I can't point him out. You know what I'm saying?
What's his race? What's his race?
I believe that he was Jewish.
Judah, you're right.
Judah. Whatever, right?
So Judah, people, that's a Jew, right? So, so what race today would the Jews be?
To me, what?
Huh? Okay, got you. Get an X. Give me X. Give me X. Chapter 13. I got you. Mm-hmm. Tell me why you think that.
What do I think? What?
Why? The greatest people on the planet Earth, right? We read about in the Bible. Those are the Jews, right?
But today. That's just what society portrays. So what's today?
Today, who are the greatest people on the planet Earth?
Who are the greatest people?
Yes.
Greatest people of all time will always be my black people.
Exactly,
my
right? Of all time. Guess what, though? Thousands of these people.
But guess what? Let me ask you this, though. How many black people do you see walking around with that Jew thing on their head?
Huh?
You feel me?
Well, what does that got to do with anything?
Because.
Show me the yarmulke in the Bible.
So do that, though? So
it's them.
I'll answer your question.
I got you. They had no flavor. They ain't got no flavor. They're lame. Okay. Right? They ain't got nothing.
But that's why we see more white people, though. That's what I'm
saying. Can I show you the Jews being called black people in the Bible?
Absolutely.
It's the book of Acts, chapter 13, verse 1. Now, there were in the church, there was in Antioch certain prophets and teachers as Barnabas and Simeon.
Those are two Jews. Barnabas and Simeon. Those are two Jews. Mm-hmm. Right?
Barnabas and Simeon, that was called nigger.
It was called what?
Nigger.
It was called what?
Nigger.
What people are called nigger? Okay, what does the word nigger mean?
You can say it however many times you want to. I'm still not going to tell you that I know what God looks like. Okay? That's just the
energy. I don't know what to do.
I've never seen him with my true
I got
God,
you. Let me ask you a question.
He is in my heart and he is my Jesus, Lord and Christ.
Can I ask you one question?
What's up? Because I'm
all back. I got you. Okay, I got you. So saying that the Jews are black, right? Uh-huh. What would that make black people?
So you said we the chosen people?
Yes. Right. But Jesus Christ is a Jew. So what that make Jesus Christ?
No, I agree with you.
So Jesus Christ is black?
Absolutely.
So you do know what he looks like?
Oh,
God. We can't. Why you got a problem with this then? Well, how come I can't put horns on this?
I don't like this because I feel like it's very disrespectful.
What's disrespectful?
Listen, let me finish.
Go ahead.
To other white people, if they believe that Jesus is white, listen, if they believe Jesus is white,
he's doing something.
Come here, Ron, come here.
I'm going to ask you a question right now.
No,
his question is his question, but I need to address something you're saying. You're saying you feel this is disrespectful because we put horns on a picture.
Absolutely.
You don't feel it's disrespectful that they cut babies out of black women's bellies?
Absolutely.
So why you ain't mad about that?
I am. I don't see you advocating that. Absolutely.
We do. We're not advocating it right now because you're talking about this picture that means nothing.
Y'all are talking about, you know.
You're saying that we're disrespecting. You're saying that we're disrespecting white people.
Look
at the back of my jacket. You mad about that? I got a white person hanging on my back. No one cares about what you're talking about. These white people don't care about you. They don't care about you. Go do that. Go do that. The government already hate us and the white people too.
That's right.
Whether you stay here with us or not, they hate you just as much as they hate me.
That's right.
Go on and advocate for them. Go ahead. They still gonna hang you like they did the sister down the street. They don't care about none of y'all. Stop being ignorant, sister. Love God so God can love you.
That's right.
Here, man.
So she mad about a KKK member that hangs niggas being hung on the shirt. That's what she mad about. Come on. What's actually going on? What are we actually talking about here, right? What is it, right? And that's why I always ask the question, why black people, right? Give me an Amos chapter 3, verse 1, right? That's kind of, that's really ridiculous, right? How y'all doing? Right, I just got fresh meat all over the place. How y'all doing? Oh, y'all don't like black people? I mean, I'm gonna ask the question. Y'all listening? Okay. Did y'all hear what he had to say? Do y'all like the back of his t-shirt?
No, they don't like it.
They should though. That's because they want to know why. That's just. Do y'all like justice? Do y'all agree with justice? Okay. The back of his shirt, is that just? Huh? You said what? You said what? So you agree? See what I'm saying, right? So white people agree to their own demise because it's justice. That's all it is, right? Give me you got it?
What you want? Amos 3 or Revelation?
What, Revelation for what?
13.
Yeah, give me, yeah, go ahead.
It's the book of Revelation, chapter 13, verse 10.
Hey, do y'all believe in the Bible before y'all leave? Do y'all believe in the Bible? Oh, okay, okay, I got you. That's cool. Hey, hey, keep thinking that way, right? Go out and live your life, right? Get as many black men as that would you like if you want. Go on, go to Cancun, Punta Kunta, do whatever you guys got to do, right? If you want to use the N-word, right, don't do it around here. But if that, you know, rocks your boat, if that's how you get off, use it, by damn it. Go ahead.
Revelation chapter 3, verse 10. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. And all we're doing is, right, giving the heathen their judgment, right? I think that's in Isaiah 34 or something like that. Go ahead.
It says, he that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword.
And that's the judgment that is coming upon these heathen, right? All ye heathen, y'all gonna get it, right?
Book of 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 23. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft.
Rebellion is as a sin of witchcraft, brother. You hear that? Yeah. You need to come stop and listen there. That'd be the case. You just rebelled, right? He understands while rebelling.
Right.
For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft.
This is all a simulation. None of this shit is real. These people that's gonna walk past, they're not real, right? Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're the main characters. These niggas they're the pedestrians on GTA, right? You run over them, you'll see them the next day. You're gonna see that same nigga the next day, right? For example, hey guys, see, there was a, like on GTA, if I were to make a little sound button, the pedestrians keep walking. Hey guys, human beings, if that's what y'all want to be called, right? You see what I'm saying? Right? Let's try this shit. Hey guys, how y'all doing? Okay, they might be main characters, right? They might be slaves in the kingdom.
Right?
I'm gonna name him Lucifer, looking at him. Things aren't gonna get right. Until you have a shot, Hamashiach, what the hell is this? I told y'all, none of this shit is real. Hey, big bro. Don't do that. Hey, big bro. He can't hear me? Finland. Cuz, none of this shit is real, bro. Come on, bro, you ain't got no scriptures. Oh, you got some good.
Book of Baruch, chapter 4, verse 6. You were sold to the nations for your destruction.
Shalaki. Brother, if you are a brother, I need you to repent. I need you to repent swiftly and speedily, right? That's your best bet by going back into that Kroger, right? Good.
Just for slaves. Beat them so hard, had them crumping like the bay. Yeah, yeah. Make it a heaven, an ultimate.